Once again, we're in our reusing content.dwg file, and as you can see, I've left it as it was at the end of the last video. Remember, we'd exploded the keyhole block and changed the geometry by adding this little line here. Now, bear in mind, all of this geometry is on layer 0. So if I create a block of that, that'll actually come in on the current drafting layer. So what we're going to do is we're going to go up to the layers panel in the home tab on the ribbon, and we're going to go to our keyhole layer, like we did previously when we created the original keyhole block over here. Now, I haven't exploded this block. What I'm going to do is redefine it. And this is where AutoCAD is extremely useful, because if you create a new block of the same name of an existing block, you are able to redefine all of the block references of that block definition in your drawing. It's really quick and easy to do. So we're on the keyhole layer, remember, and we go to the block panel on the home tab on the ribbon and click on create block, like so. Brings up the block definition dialog box. So I'm going to call it keyhole again, like so. Make sure you spell it the same way as well. So base point, I'm going to go to pick point. I'm going to use the center like I did on the previous block for the keyhole. And again, you can see there's no way I would have guessed X and Y values there. It's a little bit complex. Make sure your block unit is millimeters and you do not open it in the block editor. Leave that unticked. We'll cover that later. We're going to click on select objects like we've done previously. Little crossing selection, like so. Make sure you get everything that's going to make the new keyhole and press enter. And we're going to convert to block. Make sure that that is set. It's important this time. Otherwise, it will just retain the original objects or delete them. We want to convert to block in situ in the drawing. Again, you've got the description box if you want to add a text description. Scale uniformly is ticked. Allow exploding is ticked. Now, here's the clever bit. Because we've got the same name, watch what happens when I click on OK. It now prompts me saying, hold on a moment. Keyhole is already defined as a block in this drawing. Would you like to redefine this block reference? Now, yes, we want to, because we want our keyhole to look different. But here's the trick. When I click on redefine block, it puts not only this block as the new keyhole block, but it updates the existing keyhole block as well. And that's that redefine block reference that I was talking about. And it's really useful because it means that every other instance of that block reference will have been redefined in your drawing. So if you had 600 keyholes, they would all be redefined in the drawing, saving you hours of editing time. So when you have that opportunity to redefine a block, make sure that you do. It allows you to work much quicker and much smarter in your AutoCAD drawings.